Hare Krishna. Om Namo Bhagavate. We said also that yesterday, well, and I had been saying this from time to time, that Hari Hari, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskritya, after having offered your obeisances unto Narayan. So we also offer our obeisances unto Narayan. Why not? Of course, gopis were more interested in Krishna than Narayan. We also offer our obeisances unto Vasudev. That is what we say, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. I offer my obeisances unto Vasudev. How many Vasudevs are there? Was a question raised yesterday. What you would say? Two. Someone was present yesterday, says that today there are two Vasudevs. First of all, who is Vasudev? Son of Vasudev is Vasudev. That's the son of Vasudev is Vasudev. So Vasudev had, of course, he lost six sons. That Kamsa killed. That rascal killed six sons. But the seventh son was Balaram. And the eighth son was Krishna. Right? So son of Vasudev is Vasudev. So these are two Vasudevs. Balaram Vasudev and Krishna Vasudev. And the ninth child was a daughter. That was Subhadra. So this way, there's Krishna, Balaram, and Subhadra. So we offer our obeisances. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. And then Tataha Jaya Mudirayet. And thereafter, you glorify the glorious, well, historical events which are described in the transcendental itihasas and puranas. They are called vijay. So Mahabharat ki. So we say jai. Then Srimad Bhagavatam ki. So like that. Other scriptures are there. And tata jayam udirayet. Udirayet means they should be glorified, they should be recited, they should be studied and all that. That is udirayat. Tataha jayam, and all these scriptures are jai. And they are glorifying, broadcasting the glories of the Lord, the victorious Lord, as I was thinking. When we blow the conch shell, it is also, we broadcast the glories. Krishna, hey, hey, Krishna is now going to be appearing, going to give darshan to you. So, so we'll continue Bhagavat Mahatmya from Skanda Puran. This is the work of Srila Vyasadev. And we completed one chapter yesterday, Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya. And so I'm just doing one verse We did whole entire chapter yesterday. And we also said this is a kind of Bhagavatam, continuation of Bhagavatam. You remember? Now I will not remind you, but I'm just saying we said that. That what we are reading here is right after Krishna's departure, the events which took place right after Krishna's departure for his own abode. Then what happened? Then what did Parikshit Maharaj do? And what did Vajranav do? One in Hastinapur, one in Mathura. What did they do? Was the inquiry. That was a question raised by the 88 sages assembled in Naimisharanya. So in response to that, one chapter was recited, narrated. And then at the beginning of the second chapter, once again, very similar inquiry is made. And that is, Shandille tau samadishya paravrate sva ashramam kim katham chakratu tau tu rajano sutau vada tat vada. So after Shandile Rishi returned to his ashram, remember he was there yesterday. We talked, he was invited to give advice, do some counseling, some way out, so many doubts and some confusion and ignorance on the part of Vajranav, and he was in total anxiety as a result. Where is Braj? Where is everybody? There's hardly anybody around here. Just few of us, and the queens, and myself, and some others, but where is everybody else? Where is the population? Where is Praja, the citizens? Where is Vrindavan? I'm not able to see Vrindavan. Moraya Bhilas. Vilas kunje divovas. We pray that too, right? To Tulsi Maharani. Oh, Tulsi Maharani. Vilas kunje divovas. Not only I am able to see what goes on in these vilas kunjas, in the forest gardens of Vrindavan, but may I also enter. That is a prayer unto Tulsi Maharani. Vishaya chadiya kabe shuddha habe man kabe hama he ribo Sri Vrindavan. This is yet another prayer of our Acharya Narottam Das Thakur says, when would that day come that I will get rid of this Vishaya Vasana, Vishaya Chariya, this whole scheme of gratifying senses, enjoying spirit. When would I get rid of this? Kabe hama heribo, so that I could see Kabe hama heribo Sri Vrindavan, so that I could see Vrindavan as it is. As it is, and full manifestation of Vrindavan. So Vajranab also was not getting that full vision, full realization, full darshan of the complete glory of Vrindavan, Brajamandal Darshan, he was not getting. So uh, So they had invited Shandilya Rishi, and then he gave all good advice. You do this, you do that. Okay, and then what would happen? You will meet. If we did this and all that I have asked you to do, then Uddhav will appear. Uddhav would be pleased with your endeavors, and he will make appearance. And once he appears, he will reveal more things unto you, or he will reveal glory of Vrindavan, or he will give you eyes to see Vrindavan. So that Shandilya, after completing his homework, he had returned to his own ashram. So further inquiry is, then what happened? Then what did Parikshit Maharaj and Vajranab do? That is the question. And then So a lot had been done. In fact, they did everything that they were asked to do. And here is a small list of items of what they did. Tatastu, tatastataha. Tataha means thereafter. After what? After Shandilya Rishi, he had asked them to do various things, and he had left. So thereafter, Vishnu Ratena Shreni Mukhya Sahasrashaha Indraprastha Samanaya Mathura Sthanam Apitaha. That he brought thousands of personalities, people from Indraprastha, and settled them in Vrindavan, Mathura. Mentioned Mathura. It's also Mathura Mandal. Braja Mandal is also called Mathura Mandal sometimes. Yeah, both Braja Mandal, Mathura Mandal. And they were rich people. From rich community was invited to come. There's a lot of work to be done. The funds are also required. Rath Yatra is to be organized, so funds are necessary. So, or Vedavyas from Delhi, and he contributes, and someone else from Greater Kailash in Delhi, which is kind of Hastinapur. So Parikshit Maharaj and Indra, Vajranav, they have invited, welcomed so many big, big, rich personalities, and they're all settled in Vrindavan, in Mathura. Okay, that's one. Mathuran Brahmanas Tatra Vanarasha Puratanan. He also has invited lots of Brahmins to come and settle. And he has arranged their lodging and boarding and everything so that they could happily reside in Vrindavan. He also managed to get lots of monkeys. Puratanan, says, some old monkeys, or monkeys from the old times, maybe from Ramachandra's time. Because they had, Jai Ho, Gaurinthai Ki, they had done a lot of service to Sri Krishna in the form of Sri Ram. Then Krishna used to, the stealing butter pastimes, Krishna is to Give them some butter. Dear monkey, please come forward. Please come. Take some butter. Thank you. Thank you for what? You did so much for me, building the bridge and whatnot. But that time I was not able to reward you properly. I was just vanavasi. So here, take some butter. Thank you. So those kind of monkeys also have been invited. What is Vrindavan without monkeys? Could you imagine Vrindavan without monkeys? Monkeys have to be there. So monkeys are also welcomed. Sthapitavan, and they are all settled. Govinda gopa gopinam lila sthanani anukramat. And then, as he was asked to establish different villages all over Braja Mandal and name those villages after the pastimes of that region, and that part of Braj. So they also did this, quite a task, right? Hundreds and hundreds, maybe thousands of villages they had to establish, settle. Must have taken 50 years, a lot of time. Not that they're just chanting mantras and villages cropping up. Okay, another one. No, they had to do the whole village planning, town planning, village planning, and the whole thing, and everything from the scratch. Because it is, well, it is, it would be said by, I don't know, Jamuna would be saying, when Lord disappeared from the face of earth, from his abode, then the abode Vrindavan also, well, disappears. We already said Krishna disappears, so dham also disappears. Then we would say that, Krishna doesn't disappear, he just withdraws himself from that, from manifest. He goes into unmanifest situation, right? From pragat to aprakat. So likewise, the dham also, dham which was all there, visible and tangible, you could touch, smell and all that. So dham also takes a back seat. Brajamandal. And then what we see is Bhauma Vrindavan. It's called Bhauma Vrindavan. The Vrindavan, well, is right here. It's right here. You are sitting on the gold mine, as they say. You are sitting right on the top of Vrindavan. But what you see is not exactly the real Vrindavan. The Vrindavan is here. Just around the corner from here, just underneath, dig a little deeper, and you will. So they are building all this, erecting, settling new communities, the villages, and naming them after the pastime taken place there. So and this is also happening with the help of Shandilya Muni. Had told, I will be, at your disposal. I don't know which pastime took place where. Now do not worry, Shandilya Muni has said. I will reveal those unto you. Divya Gyan Ride Prakashita. So, Chattikara, well, I don't know where to start, but there are so many villages. Chattikara, Shaktavarth, it's called Shaktavarth. Again, apabhransh, the words get distorted and this happens and that happens and then original words or names are lost or... Yeah, so like that. So Shaktavarth. Where Chattikara is, Chattikara, there's a village with a T junction, this Bhaktivedanta Swami Marg, which used to be, and well, for a lot of people, that is still Chattikara Road, but it was named like a 40 years, 35 years ago, it was named Bhaktivedanta Swami Marg, but we have not done so much awareness, and So the Chattikara, so that's where Shaktavarth, when all the residents of Gokul, they cross Jamuna and settled between Jamuna and Govardhan at Chattikara. So what they did was they parked their carts, because they had come in the carts. So they parked carts all around, which worked like a fencing, and they stayed in the middle. So that place became known as Shakta. Shakat means cart. Shakat. Shaktavarth means like a round. Shaktavarth. So that village got the name Shaktavarth, but now it's Chattikara. Not far from there, after Ral, between Ral and Radhakund, is a village called Vasati. The residents of Raval, that is Radharani and family, Vrishabhanu, they also migrated. And they had settled at that village, which became known as Vasati. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, when did his parikrama, in the diary, there's a mention of that village and there's a description there. Okay, so Krishna had come. Finally, Krishna came. And he killed Dantavaktra. Right, not far from, well, here. So where Dantavaktra was killed, the village name is Datiha. Ha means killing. Ha means killing. Datiya, this refers to Dat, Danta, Datiha. That village got that name. Okay, like the Ayore, we were talking yesterday. Ayore Gram. Residents of Vrindavan had gone to meet Sri Krishna in Kurukshetra when Krishna had come with Balaram and others from Dwarika. At the time of sun eclipse, and the Brajabasis had gone this time we'll bring him back. And he's going to be coming, sitting in the chariot, so we'll even get rid of those horses, and who will become the horses and pull the chariot, bring him to Vrindavan. But nothing of that sort happened. In fact, Krishna one more time said, no. Yes, a promise is a promise, a gentleman's promise. Krishna had said when he was leaving Vrindavan for Mathura, he said, I say, Gopiyo, I will be just now coming. Do not be in anxiety. And then when Krishna killed Kamsa, and residents of Vrindavan also had gone to Mathura, and they were returning, And they were certainly expecting, Nanda Maharaj was expecting that Krishna also would return with them. But no, that did not happen. You know what Krishna said? Drastum eshamaha. I will come to visit you, Daddy. I will come to visit you. I will come to see you. So these were kind of two promises. One to the gopis, yes, just now coming, I will come and I will come to see you, Nanda. But then Krishna one more time said, no, sorry. My task of vinashaya cha duskritam. Anyway, this I should not say, because then we will not go through what. So Krishna again said, okay, I will be coming. Not this time, but I will come. But then finally, after having gone to Dwarka and killing some more demons, he returns, he comes to Vrindavan. And residents of Vrindavan, well, they were delighted to know that Krishna has returned. So they're all shouting, screaming, Ayore, Ayore, Ayore. He has come, he has come, he has come. He is here, he is here. He is welcome, Ayore, Ayore. So wherever he was greeted by residents of Vrindavan, Krishna was greeted. That village became known as Ayore Gram. So there's one village called Ayore Gram. And like that. Chaumuha, Chaumuha, Chaumuha. You know Chaumuha? You better know this. When you go from Vrindavan to Delhi by old highway, not the Jamuna Express, not far from Chattikara, maybe 10 kilometers, 10 kilometers hoga? Yeah, about 10, 15 kilometers in the direction of Delhi is Chaumuha. Chau is four, Muha is Muk, four-headed, something four-headed. So that is where Brahma offered his prayers to Sri Krishna after Brahma Vimohan Leela. So that village named Chaumuha. Sarpoli, named after Sarp. Which serpent is this? Aghasur. Bhaigao. People became fearful when Nanda Maharaj was arrested by who? Varun's agents are. Then everyone was scared, very much afraid. So there is a place called Nandaghat and there is a village called Bhaigao. Everyone was afraid. So Bhaigao, another name. Mat, where they used to make all the earthen pots, all the supply, all the exports of, just within Braj from that place, the place named Mat. Like that, as you go during Brajamandal Parikrama, we have experienced every village has a name which has origin in Krishna's pastime. So it's one of the pastime of Krishna and village is named after. So these two prabhus, two kings in fact, they have done all this. Okay? And then they have dug different kundas, this kund, that kund, and then there are hundreds and thousands of kundas. Why not? Big, small, there's so many. And Braj is, Braj means it's unlimited. We heard of that definition yesterday, Vyapanat, because Vyapti is all over. So many kundas, so many lakes, digging and naming after Kusum Sarovar and Govind Kund and this and that. Okay, then Shivadi Sthapaneno, even Shiva temples, Shiva Lingas, were established by Vajranav. Shiva, he acts like a Dikpal. In Mathura, Dik is direction, Pal protector. Protector of directions. So there are four directions, main directions. So in east of Mathura, there is a Pipaleshwar, Mahadev, who protects Mathura. And the south of Mathura is Rangeshwar Mahadev. He is a Dikpal. And in the, which direction is next? Southwest. West is Bhuteshwar Mahadev. And the north is Gokarneshwar Mahadev. In four directions, four Shivas established by Vajranav. And then all over Braj also, there's Gopeshwar Mahadev in Vrindavan, Chakreshwar in Govardhan, and Nandagram has Nandeshwar and Kameshwar Mahadev, like this big name, but others also. So it's mentioned here, Shiva Adisthapanena. And then on the top of that, Govinda Hari Deva Adiswarupa Aropanena cha. He established, installed so many deities. In Mathura, he installed Keshav Dev. In Vrindavan, Govinda Dev. In Govardhan, Hari Dev. And in Dauji, Baladev, like these four Devas. They are not demigods, but they are Adi Dev. Installed by Vajranav. And when this was all done, what did all this do? Krishnaika bhakti sve rajye tatana cha mamodaha. As a result, Krishna consciousness was spreading with these projects. I will not repeat, you know what was done. So Krishna consciousness was spreading every nook and corner of Mathura Mandal. Tatana, expanding. Krishna consciousness was expanding. And Momoda, and everyone was becoming happy and joyful, delighted. Elevation in Krishna consciousness was taking place. And as a result, Krishna kirtana tatparaha praja, the citizens, muditaha, very joyful, and tasya, that is Krishna kirtana tatparaha. They're all becoming very, very expert in what? In performance of kirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare, Krishna Kirtan Tatparaha. Well, this is Nama Kirtan. There is also Leela Kirtan. You know that when you recite Leela, that is also Kirtan. Leela Kirtan, there's a Nama Kirtan, there's a, like that, Swarup Kirtan, Roop Kirtan. These are all features of Kirtan. Nam is one kind of kirtan. Well, kirtan means glory. So, chanting his holy name is one kind of, starts from there. And then there's a nama kirtan, there's a leela kirtan. So all these kirtans, tatparaha, they will become very, very expert, and paramananda sampannaha, paramananda. Sampanna, they were all getting enriched, equipped, enriched with what? Parama Ananda Sampanna. Okay, so now as this happened, now the queens were still kind of missing. Well, certainly they are missing Krishna, missing where is the Vrindavan, where are the residents of the Vrindavan, residents, eternal residents, and all that. So they were in total anxiety, as was Vajranavan. That is why he had approached Shandilya Rishi And now the queen, 16,000 of them, headed by Rohini, was mentioned, right? But not Balaram's mother Rohini, we said, made a distinction. This is another Rohini, Queen Rohini, who was heading that group of the 16,000 queens. So they are wondering and wandering everywhere, huh? In this anxiety. Oh, where is everybody? Where is Vrindavan? I don't want to see Vrindavan. So as they were exploring and going around, they luckily, ekada means what? Once upon a time. Once upon a time this happened. Krishna patniha tu Krishna virha aturaha. They virha atura. They were very, very anxious, desperate, feeling vacant. Where is Krishna and his abode and others? Where are they? So they came across Kalindi. Kalindi muditam viksha. They saw Kalindi. What kind of Kalindi did they see? You don't seem to be. I'm also seeing some of you struggling to keep your eyes. But you are doing like a yogi, half open, half closed. Because you are making endeavor to keep them open, so they're opening only half opening, not fully, full bloom. But you get credit for endeavor. We appreciate you want to stay awake. So, viksha, let's talk of viksha saw. I am seeing you. The queen saw. Queen saw Kalindi. Kalindi. But when they saw Kalindi, how did she look like? Muditam. Very happy. Very joyful. Ecstatic. Jamuna mayaki. And well, they said, yatha vayam Krishna patnyaha tvamapi shobhane. Like the way we are the queens of Sri Krishna, you are also the queen. So this is something similar, right? Between you and us, what is common? Krishna is a common, or we are Krishna's husbands. You are and we are. This is something common. But there's some difference also we are experiencing, and difference is vayam viraha dukkhartha. We are suffering because of the separation from the Lord. We are full of suffering, agonized. But you are not. But you are not. Tvam na. We are, but you are not. So this is the difference. Kalindi tadvada. Why is this difference? Although we are wives of the Krishna's wives. We are wives of Krishna. That is common. But there is something not very common. There's big difference, vast difference between you and us. You seem to be very, very happy. And look at us, our miserable face. You could read everything. The face is index of mind. So you could read our mind, hearts. Just looking at our faces, look at us. And this is not fair. You are happy, we are unhappy. Is this fair? It's not fair. So how come? How do you manage to remain happy? Please. tell us. Tat shrutva, by hearing this, smayamana sa kalindi, that Kalindi was kind of smiling. Smiling to hear that kind of inquiry. And then she, out of her kindness, she spoke. What did she say? Atma Ramasya Krishnasya Dhruvam Astiradhika. We heard this yesterday also. Is Shandila Rishi said something very similar. Very, very similar. Krishna Shatasya Radhika Tu Atma. They said. Tasya Krishna Atma Radhika. That was yesterday's statement. And today we are hearing from Kalindi. Same truth has been repeated here. Atma Ramasya Krishnasya Dhruvam Asti Radhika. Atma Ramasya Krishnasya. Krishna is Atma Ram. Krishna is self-satisfied because his self is Radha. Because of Radha, he is happy. Radha makes him happy. Of course, we should not think here that that had happened in Jagannath Puri. That in the spirit of glorifying Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I said. Anyway, that's different devotees, they would come and write some their realizations, some poems, and they would like that they reach Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they are read by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So one such prayer had come. Anyway, I want to make it brief, but so this person who had written some glorification. So these poems would reach Swarup Damodar first, secretary to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And if it is philosophically sound, then he would pass that on to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If not, in the dustbin. So this one particular poem, of course, he had a good intention to glorify Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Jagannath. And he said, is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is... No, is, I said, not ki. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Atma of Jagannath. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Atma of Jagannath, he said. Wholeheartedly, he's glorifying. It's a big thing, he's Atma. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Atma of Jagannath. The Swarup Damodar, he rejected that poem. When I read that, I also was happy before reaching Swarup Damodar. I was not sure what Swarup Damodar was going to do with the prayer, but when I read up to there, sounds nice. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is, Atma, is a soul, he's soul of Jagannath. Such a nice glorification of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But the Swarup Damodar took that as, means you are making a distinction. Jagannath has a Atma and Deha. Jagannath has spirit, the Atma, soul and the body. So Jagannath, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Atma and the rest is just the body. this material body, like we think like the Atma. Atma and the body. Spirit, soul and the body. So Swarupa Damodar took in that spirit and said, no, get out of here. He threw that away. You understood? I won't say more. Maybe I did not say enough or... But... So it's not like that. Radha is Atma, it's not in that... Radha is Radha. We'll be hearing that very soon. So, it's Alladhani Shakti of the Lord. All Allad. All Anand. Krishna gets, that is from Radha. And also living entities, Chaitanya Charitamrita describes. Two parties derive happiness from Radharani. The Supreme Soul and the Spirit Soul also gets Allad from Radharani. This is, I think, the Ramanand Rai Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Samvad dialogue. I think it is there, described like that. So she is Shakti, energy, and Krishna is energetic. He is Shaktiman. They cannot be separated. So in that sense, you can't separate Krishna from Radha, Radha from Krishna. Okay, so... Tasya dasya prabhavena viraho asmana samsprashet. So Kalindi revealed, you know, I look happy, right? I look happy to you. The reason is that I have become a servitor. I accept the service of I serve Radharani. I serve Radha. I serve Radha. I assist Radha. I assist Radha. And this is what Mahatmanastu Mam Partha Daivi Prakriti Masritaha. Krishna said that in Bhagavad Gita. That person is a Mahatma. Mahatmanastu Mam Partha Daivi Prakriti Masritaha. So what is that Daivi Prakriti? Daivi Prakriti is Radharani. And then Laukik Prakriti is Durga, like that. So Daivi Prakriti Masritaha. Vina Radha Prasadena Krishna Prasadam Na Vidyate. There's some statement like that. Without Radharani's mercy, we don't get Krishna. We have no access to Krishna. And then we, Radharani's mercy, we get that in parampara and all that is also there. So, Yasya Prasadat Bhagavat Prasadam. They have taken shelter of Radharani, our acharyas, or gurus, so we serve them. And our service reaches Radharani, like that. So because I serve Radharani, this is the reason I never feel separation from Krishna. I always feel that I'm in close proximity. Krishna is just around from where I am. Hari, Hari. I always feel my Guru Maharaj is always next to me, Prabhupada would say. Prabhupada said many times. I always feel my Guru Maharaj is always next to me. And he's telling me, do this, don't do this. He would say that. So Tasya eva amsha vistara sarva sarva krishna nayikaha. And all of us, all the queens of Sri Krishna are ansha, are expansions of Radharani, right? And because Radharani is never separated from Krishna, so is the case of all the queens. All the queens are also having that access to Krishna, well, through Radharani, right? They're ansha of Krishna, they're parts and parcels of Radharani. Radharani is facing Krishna all the time. Radha and Krishna are always face to face. They could never be separated. And these queens, when they are well connected with Radharani, they are serving Radharani. So Kalindi says, then for queens also there is no separation. They are never separated from the Lord. And he says, sa eva sa. Complete truth has been said in these three small words. Sa eva sa. Sa, who is sa? Krishna. Saha Krishna. Eva means certainly. Sa Radha. Sa Radha. Saha Krishna. Saha eva sa. Radha is Krishna. And as if this was not enough, same thing is said one more time in sa, sa eva asti. Sa, sa eva asti. That Krishna is Radharani only. Radha is Krishna, Krishna is Radha. And one more item has been added here. Bamsi tat prema rupika. And their prem, Radha Krishna pranaya vikratir alhadani shakti rasmat, is another statement. The Radha Krishna pranaya, the prem, and pranaya is even higher than prem, much higher. A higher altitude, very solid prem, is called pranaya. There's also called sneha, man, pranaya. There are so many. Above prem, there are 6-7 kinds of loves. Love of Godhead is described, mentioned. Pranaya is one of them. So that pranaya or that prem of Radha Krishna appears in the form of bamsi, bamsi, bamsi vibhushita karan avanira dabhat. That bamsi and that bamsi vadan, and that is a manifestation of the love of Radha and Krishna, says that bamsi is. And Sri Krishna Nakha Chandra Ali Sangat Chandra Vali Smrata. And well, where does Chandra Vali fit? So this is Kalindi Jamuna speaking. She says that Chandra Vali, she serves Chandras. She serves moons, not just one moon, but rows of moons. One moon, another moon, another moon, another moon. So which moons are these? Nakhachandra. The toes of Lord's lotus feet, they are Chandra. So how many Chandras are there? 10 chandras, 10 moons are there. And Chandravali is just busy serving those moons, Nakachandra, and hence her name is, what is her name? Chandravali, she gets his name, Chandravali. Yushmakam api krishnena viraho naiva sarvataha. You also, in fact, you are not separated, you are not away, but you are not just aware. Kintu evam na janitha. But you do not know that you are always with all the queens, are always with the Lord. And hence, you are feeling this separation. And then Kalindi said, you know, once this also was a experience or thought of the gopis. Krishna was in Mathura. Gopis were thinking that way. Oh, he's away. He's away from Vrindavan. He left us. He left us behind. And he has gone to Mathura, and we have been separated, and they are feeling the pangs of separation. And Lord was getting this, there were exchanges of letters also between Mathura and Vrindavan residents. There was a postman doing a speed post. I was going back and forth. It was mentioned like that. And messages were coming. And Krishna replying, and but that was not enough. Or Krishna had come to know how gopis are missing him, feeling separated. Then Kalindi is saying, then Krishna sent Uddhav, and then Uddhav managed. Uddhav pacified, Uddhav Sandesh, which was Krishna's Sandesh, Krishna's message. Uddhav was a carrier of that message. But Uddhav did this for Krishna. And he was successful in the mission. They all were pacified, satisfied. So You also, if you get to meet Uddhav, then he could do the same thing, same magic, same formula, same mantra, same message, same kind of sadhu sang. He will offer to you, and like those gopis were satisfied, again felt connected with the Lord, that could happen to you also. So what you need is your meeting with Uddhav. So when all the queens heard this, they were very delighted. Oh, there is some, we got the clue now, there is some ray of hope. But could you tell us where to find Uddhav? You mentioned Uddhav, that's, thank you very much for that, but where to find him? What is his address? How does he look like? How would we recognize him? And then the queen, Kalindi, says here, Uddhav was the last one to meet Sri Krishna, okay? Before Krishna departed from his own abode, one of the last persons Krishna met was Uddhav. And there was Maitreya Muni also. And then no more meeting, no appointments, no interviews, nothing. Krishna departed. At that time, Krishna had asked Uddhava to go. Go, you go to Badrikashram. And before going there, Krishna had recited whole Gita in 11th canto of Bhagavatam. There is a big, long dialogue between Uddhava and Krishna. Because otherwise Uddhava, no. If you are going back home, I would like to come. And I had to come with you. No, I will come. Don't leave me behind. Then Krishna had said, okay, I will stay. Oh, then I could stay also. But then Krishna said, I will stay in the form of Bhagavatam. I will continue to stay in this world in the form of Bhagavatam. And whole Bhagavatam was recited for sake of Uddhava also, some Bhagavad recitation. And then Uddhava said, if Bhagavatam, you stay in the form of Bhagavatam, then I will associate with Bhagavatam. And association with Bhagavatam is association with Krishna. So Kalindi is mentioning that he was asked to go to Badrikashram, sadhana bhumi badari. And that is a sadhan bhumi, place of sadhana. And then phala bhumi, praja bhumi, one sadhana bhumi, and one is phala bhumi. You get phal, fruit of your sadhana, you get in Vrindavan. Some distinction between other tirthas, other places, holy places, and Vrindavan. Vrindavan, you get the fruit of your sadhana, sadhan phal, sadhan siddhi. So Krishna, so he obeyed the command of the Lord and he went to Badrikashram. He resides there, but he also resides in Vrindavan. Because when he had come to Vrindavan, he was sent to Vrindavan to meet residents of Vrindavan, parents and gopis also. He was so much impressed. That visit was so much enlightening. Especially by gopis praying for Krishna. Gopi bhav, Radha bhav. So he had prayed, I would like to just stay here. As some creeper, some grass, so that when gopis come, they would trample all over me. And I will get a lot of dust of their lotus feet. I deserve that. I need that. So I would like to just stay in Vrindavan. So that thought and that prayer was there, and that also was fulfilled, and Uddhava was allowed to stay in Vrindavan. And address is Giri Govardhana Nikate Sakhisthale Tad Rajakamaha Rajakamaha. Kamna, desire of what? Getting dust of gopis' feet, Radha's feet. He's staying there, where? Near Giriraj, Govardhan. There's a place called Sakhisthal. You know where Kusum Sarovar is? There's a Sakhisthal there. You know where Uddhav Kund is? Those who do Govardhan Parikrama, after going Puchrika, Lota Baba, and going through that Govardhan village, also going towards Radha Kund, some 4 or 5 kilometers before Radha Kund. Of course, to the right is Uddhav Kund. So in that region, he resides. And mentioned here, Kalin is mentioning, he's residing there in the form of the Ankura, Valli, the creepers, and some sprouts, some grass growing there. So Uddhavo Noonam, certainly he resides there. And one more very interesting mention is Atma Utsava Swarupatvam Harina. Uddhav is personification of the Krishna Utsavas, Krishna festivals. Krishna festival, wherever there's a Krishna festival, Krishna conscious festival, that is Uddhav. Uddhav manifests there. There's a personification of the Utsav is Uddhav. And from Uddhav, there is a Utsav, and this Utsav gives Utsaha. One becomes enthusiastic. When you come to the festival, this festival, that festival, what does that do? One thing that does is you are inspired. You're inspired, enthusiastic. You become utsaha, then nishchaya dhairya, like that. So, atma swarup. So then Kalindi is asking, you all the queens, take Vajranav, take Parikshit Maharaj, and you all go to the Sakhisthal near Giriraj, or part of Giriraj, in fact. And when you go there, well, don't go empty-handed. Take some instruments with you, because when you go there, you have to perform Utsav, Sankirtan Mahotsav. You have to perform Sankirtan festival. So take Veena, Venu, Mardangai, Kirtana, Kavyadi, Sarasa Sangitai, Utsava Arabdhavyaha. Utsava Arabdhavyaha. Let festival begin. Let festival begin. Utsava Arabdhavyaha. And Sangeet, my Utsav, full of musical kirtan, and of course, a lot of ras, saras, should be saras, juicy festival, nectarian festival, with instruments, veena, venu, mridangai, these instruments. You take, you go there, perform the festival. Okay, so that is what iti shrutva prasannaha. So when they heard this from Kalindi, all the queens, they rushed to King Parikshit and Vajranav. And they narrated, they shared all this, what Kalindi had to say. And they also had heard from another source that you do this, and then Uddhav will be, you will meet Uddhav. And now the queens also have found out where Uddhav could be met and what has to be done. So immediately they got into action, and they all have rushed and reached their Sakhisthal. Vrindaranye Sakhisthale Krishna Sankirtana Mohasavaha. So Utsav, Kirtan festival began. And so that festival was wonderful, wonderful. We only say wonderful. Wonderful meaning a lot of things. Wonderful festival. One thing was they were totally into this festival. Chanting, dancing, singing, playing instruments, and totally absorbed, like some of you are. Mahaprasade Govinde. Then your absorption is interrupted. Okay, last few statements to go. So it was an amazing festival. So one thing that has done to them, they have forgotten all else. They are very much there. They are very much there. They are present, not only physically, but mentally, intellectually, emotionally. Their whole existence is right there. Shranuta datta chitto, kind of, with full focus and attention. And so outcome of this was, there comes tataha pashyatsu. They all saw him. Sarveshu tranagulma chayata, coming out from the grass and the creepers, a personality appeared. Ah, jagamo uddhavaha, Uddhav appeared. Shragvi, he has a garland around his neck. Shamaha is just like, this is Uddhav. He is Swarup Siddha Uddhav. His Swarup, his form is just like that of Krishna. Even complexion is like Krishna. Sham is also Ghanasham. Not only that, Pitambara Avrataha. Even wearing Pitambar Vastra, yellow, dazzling yellow garments. And it is also said that he never went to the tailor to get some clothes stitched for him. Whenever he was in need of some clothes, he would just get Mahaprasad from Krishna. Maha, maha, garlands. A garland or clothes. So he would put on Krishna's clothes, his prasad. And then he would even more look like Krishna. Gunjamala dharaha. And he was wearing mala of gunjas. You know, this is very special. Krishna wears this. So he also has prasadi mala around his neck. And gayan, while singing, he's appearing. Or as he's appearing, he's singing. What is he singing? Vallavi vallabham. Vallavi vallabham, Vallavi vallabham, Muhu, he says, Muhu, means again and again and again, he is singing. Vallavi vallabh, vallabh, Radha vallabh, Gopi vallabh, Vallavi vallabh. Vallabhi is Radha, vallabh is Krishna. Vallavi vallabh, like Kishore, Kishori, Kishore, Kishori, like that. Madhav, Madhavi, you could say Madhav and Madhavi. Madhavi, Radha, Madhav, Krishna. So Vallavi, Vallavam, chanting these names. And festival has become even more excited. He's also singing, the others were also singing. And okay, so then Drishtva Sri Krishna Rupinam. So Uddhav, looking just like Krishna as he was seen. So he was greeted and he was seated on some special asana and Pujitaha says, Pujayas Chakru, and he was worshipped. Okay, so now the team is complete. All those who are missing Krishna and missing Vrindavan, missing residents of Vrindavan, all those queens and Vajranab and Parikshit, and then Uddhav, part of the team. Now, so there will be further dialogue. Now Uddhav will speak. Some others also are going to be speaking glories of Bhagavatam, speaking glories of Bhagavat Mahatmya. So we will hear from Uddhav, we will hear from our other personalities. Brahma is also going to speak. Shiva will be speaking. Vishnu will speak. And so we'll continue, to be continued. Hari Bol.